Ladies and gentlemen, this is a message from Her Majesty's Government Anti-Terrorism Unit. The terrorism count in London today is medium to severe. Please be very vigilant. A child with a backpack may be a terrorist. The person sitting next to you may be Al-Qaeda. If you see anyone looking suspicious, and by suspicious I mean standing around aimlessly, please report them to the man with the megaphone immediately in order to make sure that we can live in a peaceful and safe country. Hand over your liberty for freedom. The message from your government loves you, your government needs you to keep on paying taxes. Who cares about the public cuts and the austerity measures? Who cares about the invasion of Libya? Keep paying your taxes. What we need is more of your money. We need either 22% or 40% of your earnings, because you are a citizen of a government. Your job is to pay taxes. You are not free. You are a meaningless number on a government computer screen. And it is your job to make sure that we can invade other countries for their oil or diamonds or gold or children. Ladies and gentlemen, don't worry, we have now destroyed the terrorist nation of Iraqistan. We are now destroying the terrorist nation of Libyastan. If you pay us enough tax, we'll invade Brazil. They've got good coffee there. To your desk and go and fiddle some numbers around on a computer screen. Stop standing around here wasting valuable working time. Your job needs you. Do not follow your dreams. Go back to your office. Put on a suit. You with a leather jacket. Come on, get a job. This isn't funny. Do not laugh. We need you to work harder and harder and harder to rescue the economy. Please help a stray. If you see a stray human being, take them to Savile Row, put them in a suit, and report them to your nearest office. Ladies and gentlemen, do not stand around here listening to the crazy man with the megaphone. You have better things to do, like working 10 hours a day in a job you hate. And to add insult to injury, let's put you in a glass and metal and concrete cage. You can have water cooler chat with the other office drones and talk about last night's Coronation Street. Dissolve your brain into fantasy and alcohol and cigarettes. Hold on, anyone got a lighter? Hypocrisy is the name of the game. Ladies and gentlemen, you have all been very, very naughty human beings for standing around here and enjoying yourselves. Go back to your jobs. Go back to your office. Your lunch break is over. This is a serious, serious matter. David Cameron and George Osborne need you to pay more tax.
That's a brilliant song.
Do not for 1 second think you are free. We have your birth certificate, which means that we own you. You are a British subject. And your new future king, Prince William, says, work harder. Thank you for the palaces. Thank you for the holiday. Thank you for the big royal wedding, which cost £40 million. But hey, it's money well spent. The royals are better than you. They are much better than you. It's why they're called royals, okay? You are peasants. So do not stand around here listening to me. Get back to work. And don't forget to buy more things from Topshop as well. Because if you buy more things from Topshop, you might look like Kate Moss. And then men will love you more. It's true. Ladies and gentlemen, know the difference between a good Arab and a bad Arab. A good Arab gives his oil. A bad Arab wants to be sovereign and independent. Support your government's actions against bad Arabs.
Going off from saying that... Going off from just saying life's just a ride, like Bill Hicks says, it probably is just a ride. If life is like Bill Hicks says it is, then we're witnessing a very, very, very spooky ride indeed. Someone or something is in the driving seat, or is there? Is there actually one in the driving seat in this world?
It's a bunch of gangsters.
Around 5 rows from the back, you will probably find corporation employees fighting one another for the seats in front. And about 10 rows behind them, you will have the politicians all fighting to get to the same seats. JFK probably almost made it to about the second row, but we all know what happened to him. Bill Hicks never actually stated anywhere within that joke in this show that we should actually just sit back. He sure didn't. He used comedy. It was his way of getting to know the ride. Now, if it is just a ride, somewhere inside or outside of the universe, there is a stop switch of some kind. Is this switch on the ride? Is it at the front? Is this like a fairground ride? Is the ride really operated by a traveller with an alcohol problem? It often does seem that way. Now, let's take this deeper. If it's like a roller coaster ride with dips and troughs along the route or whatever would happen if the majority woke up to the fact that it really is a ride, is it worth trying to get to the front to see nothing driving it? What would you do if you had the controls? Is it a ride that will stop abruptly or does it get slower near the end? Is there a water splash, ladies and gentlemen? In my imagination, I am seeing a few at the back of this ride. They have started to stand up.
Once you've realised there's nothing to worry about, you can just have fun. You don't have to do anything. Nobody has authority over you. You can just do whatever you want. But then you can get bored and decide, oh, I need a bit of an edge on it. Put it back on and go into the office. Move bits of paper around as though they were important. Some of those numbers on them. Talking about sterling silver that no longer has any connection to the bits of paper with the numbers on in your wallet. Never wondered what that's all about. We could go to the Bank of England and see if they'll give us £20 for our £20 notes, and they'll take it and they'll hand it back and say, here's your £20, that's all it's worth. Not worth anything. We all run around as though it's important. I mean, what a farce. What are we doing running around after these bits of paper?
You're affecting English people like our...
It's all insane, ladies and gentlemen. But what do you do when you realise it's all insane? You have to learn tricks not to be committed under the mental health act. But we learn them and we can pull it off. So we don't even worry about that. And is there a point to all this? I think there is, don't you, ladies and gentlemen? I think I've got a little quote coming on. Do you want to do it, Charlie? That's what I do. Is there a point to all this? Life is just a ride, ladies and gentlemen. You can roll up, get your tickets for the ride of life here. There are thrills and spills, ups and downs. But it's just a ride, ladies and gentlemen. And you can leave it any time you want to, but some people do take it so terribly, terribly seriously.
They do, yeah.
They do, don't they? I mean, we do, don't we?
In uniform in order to perform a search, and even in order to perform a search, they must have my consent. So when they come up to me and ask me for my name, I don't have to give them my name.
Hey, natural law!
If I came up to you in the street and asked you for your name and your address, would you give it to me?
I would. Sorry.
You most probably wouldn't. So why would you do it to a police officer? And as you can notice, the police are inside the building protecting the corporation, the company Topshop, instead of out here with the public, whom they serve. Are you not a civil servant, sir? Are you a civil servant, sir? You swore oath to the Queen, sir, to protect us, the public, sir. Then why do you protect these guys, huh? Do you not have anything to say? Do you find it right that you can chuck me on the ground, tie up my legs, put my arms behind my back and handcuff me? Is that okay? For what?
Everything is okay.
For what?
For being a human being, that's your crime.
For doing what I want to do. For walking down the street. I have done nothing wrong. Even this morning, the police stole my neighbour's car. The police are the biggest gang in the world.
Yep.
The biggest gang in the world. Who do you think own the government? What? The royal family, what? You think that they own the country? You think that they own you? Nobody owns you. You don't have to do anything they tell you. You are free human beings. You're made of flesh and blood. You can do as you like, as you please. When you die, are you going to take all these clothes with you? All the cars, all the diamond rings that children were killed for? No! I'm 20 years old. Listen to the words I speak. I speak like he's 30 years old. And you think I listen to everybody? I've signed out for myself. Don't just listen to what you're told. Go find out for yourself. We have the internet, we have books, we have libraries. Find out this information for yourself. Don't listen to the TV. Don't listen to what you read in the newspapers. It's all lies. And if you think it's true, find out for yourself. It's all a bunch of lies. You're being lied to. You're being manipulated.
Yeah.
Welcome to the EU-SSR. We're finally united under the holy faith of consumerism.
Yay!
Go and buy more stuff that you don't need. It's the only way to save the economy and the planet.
Yay!
Don't believe anything we say. Believe the mainstream media. They never told you any lies. The whole Osama bin Laden thing, believe the Americans. It doesn't matter that you have no proof whatsoever. The Americans tell you it happens. I'm sure it happens. They always told us the truth.
Always.
Always. We like to think back in 2003, all the reasons we went to Iraq was all true.
All true.
The American government can be trusted. Crazy man with a megaphone cannot be trusted.
No, never.
Go building 7,
ladies and gentlemen, get back to work. Your manager needs you. Having fun.
Oh, that's good. There you go.
Ladies and gentlemen, to exit the Matrix, come and see the man with the megaphone and take the red pill. I can show you the pill, but you have to take it. If you choose to ignore reality, you will wake up tomorrow, you'll still be an office drone, you'll still be paying your taxes, you'll still be miserable and separated, you'll still be getting drunk every night and arguing with your family and living in a concrete jungle. Or you can take the red pill, and I can show you how far down the rabbit hole of reality really goes. And I know that many of you are thinking, oh my God, he's been watching too many films.
But what are films? Films are metaphors for reality. Films are artistic expressions to try and tell you the truth. Do you know why art exists? Art exists because, as Jack Nicholson says, you can't handle the truth. So we have to put it in Hollywood films so that maybe you'll digest it. Just planting seeds. Uh-oh, the police are here clearing the way because you're actually blocking other people's shopping time. You need to let the drones walk past.